Hey everyone, it's your girl Sanj. Welcome back to my channel. Y'all, today I have my robe on and the pink light in the background, okay? Because we're trying to set a mood, okay? A mood to talk about love and to really get real about what it looks like when a man is wasting your time. Y'all, let me tell you that I have had many a time, wasted by many a man. And that is why I am here to share these tips with you to try to save y'all some time, some heartache, and you know, stress on your hairline, because time is so valuable, y'all. God gives us, you know, a finite time here on earth. We're trying to walk with Him. We're trying to walk in purpose. We're trying to have fun. We're trying to build careers. We're trying to learn how we are. There's so much stuff to do. And one thing that there's not time to do is have it wasted by someone whose intentions are not really for you. So I hope that these tips are gonna help you. Ooh, be wide-eyed when you're out here in these dating streets so that you can discern who has good intentions for you and who's wasting your time. So if you are new here, welcome. I'm Sanj. I'm so glad you're here. I would love to see you back around here. Go on and hit that young subscribe button. You can get notified every time I post. We talk about love, life, and locks here on this channel. That's my plug. So without further ado, we'll get right into these tips. Okay, y'all. So the first way to know if a man is wasting your time is if you find yourself in a situationship. I know it's the 21st century, but let me tell you, situationships have never been situations that are well positioned to lead towards long-term, happy, fulfilling relationships and marriages, and they're not today. I truly believe, and this is my personal opinion, but I've seen it happen that in a situation where a man meets a woman where he's really interested in her, he's not gonna wait months and months to make that a committed exclusive relationship. He's not gonna leave her in limbo having to ask to define the relationship and what's going on here, because he's gonna be driving that timeline, wanting to lead the timeline in the sense of, hey, you know, I would love to lock this down, okay? And if you're over here lingering, it's, you know, it's not yet exclusive or committed, and you've hit, you know, the 2-3 months mark of just kind of hanging out, it's probably a situation where he might be wasting your time. Which leads me to my second point. When you can tell a man is wasting your time is if he uses phrases around hanging out as opposed to dating. And y'all, I may be old school for this, but again, I have seen this to be true. Hanging out is cool. Hanging out is something that friends do. When a man is interested in a woman and wanting to pursue her in a dating relationship, you're not hanging out. You're dating. And what that means, you may be actually hanging out in terms of, you know, chill and watch a movie on the couch, but it's intentional. It's a date. It's planned. There's leadership and initiative taken there. It's not just a, oh, you know, come by my place. No. Dates and putting plans into what you're going to be doing together, especially in the early stages before you're kind of, you know, doing more hanging out, that is super important, and it can give you an idea of how serious a man is about a relationship, looking for a relationship, and also his ability to pursue. Which leads me to my third point, which is one way you can tell if a man is wasting your time is if he is not pursuing you. And when I say pursue, I'm not talking about, oh, you know, you can't say initiate the first date, or, oh, you can't go up and give him your number. No, like this is the 21st century, right? But what I am saying is a man who is truly interested in you will pursue you. And what that means is he will fight for your time. When you're out here living your best life, doing your thing, hanging out with your friends, sipping your tea, you know, pursuing the things that make you happy and the things that God has called you to do, Your time is very valuable, and a man will need to pursue you and fight for that time and show himself worthy of receiving some of your precious time, because again, we established that time is precious. So I don't say this in some sort of weird, unhealthy power dynamic sense. I say it from a real, you know, been there. If, you know, they're not reaching out and texting you, asking when the next time they can see you, or making plans, they may be wasting your time. And y'all, I have been there. I've been the one texting old dude, talking about, you know, oh, what are you doing? Trying to set up dates after a couple times. It's just like, are you really into this? And the truth was, they weren't. Okay? They were wasting my time. So you want that pursuit, right? And in a long-term relationship, you're both pursuing one another. That's one of the things that keeps it hot and spicy over the long term. So you want to see that pursuit early on. And if it's not there, he might be wasting your time. The fourth way you can tell that a man might be wasting your time is if he doesn't talk about you to his family, or if there has been no interaction, you know, between yourself and his family over phone call, over FaceTime, in person. I would say within the first 6 months to a year, but leaning more towards that 6 months mark. Y'all, a man who's really excited about a woman and who can see a future with her is going to want to talk to his family about her. That could be, you know, telling his mom, hey, I met this really awesome woman. It could be telling his brother. It could be, you know, introducing you on FaceTime when their parents call while you're on a date. It could be anything like that. But if you find someone keeping you a quote unquote secret from the family, and you've been dating for a little bit, it could be a sign that they may not be ready to take things to the next level in terms of a long-term relationship. And they might be wasting your time, because someone who's excited is generally going to be excited about telling people that they love about this, you know, person that they're really excited about. The fifth sign that a man might be wasting your time is if he does not claim you on social media, with the caveat that he is someone who's very active on social media. Some people aren't social media people. That is one thing. Some people might not even have social media accounts, and that's another thing. But if you are dating someone who is active on social media, they post regularly, it's been, you know, 5+ months, and you're nowhere on their social media, not even on Instagram stories, it's highly likely they're wasting your time. And the reasoning is, someone who's really excited about someone they're dating, you know, they're low-key gonna wanna show you off. And I don't mean that in any sort of, you know, problematic sense. Instagram, Facebook, other platforms like that is where we showcase highs. It's where we showcase exciting things. It's where we, you know, update people who we may or may not be in touch with on the regular about what's going on. And there's a sense of pride and excitement when, you know you're talking to somebody, they like you, you like them, they cute, you cute, and you low-key slide them, you know, onto your social media like, oh, you know, look what I got, look what's going on. And that goes both ways. So I'm not saying you're obligated to post anything, definitely not, in terms of not obligated there, but it generally is a sign of a very social media active man. If there's no sight of the person that they're dating, that they might be wasting that person's time. The sixth way that you can tell someone may be wasting your time is if they tell you that they don't know how they feel about marriage, or they think marriage is just a piece of paper. So some people hold this opinion, and I'm not throwing any shade on that. People have different, you know, opinions for seeing things that way. But according to the Bible, marriage is a beautiful thing. It is something that God loves. It's ordained by God. And, you know, it's something to be held in high esteem, something that is sacred. And so if you are a woman who desires to get married, regardless of your religious background, you're going to want to be with someone who also holds that same esteem and reverence towards marriage. So if someone mentions that they may not really be about that life, or they don't know how they feel about it, it doesn't mean they're a bad person. It's no shame on the shade on that person. It just means that you all may not be aligned, and thus they may be wasting your time because you're someone, you know, who wants to move and build a relationship with the end goal of being able to get married and spend the rest of your lives together. And the last way that you can tell that a man is wasting your time is if he does not talk about the future with you. Y'all, whether we notice it or not, we're always thinking about the future. And a man who is serious or really interested in a woman is gonna be thinking about the future. And I'm not just talking about kids or, you know, marriage or things like that. I'm talking about considering you and his future decisions when he's going on trips. Considering you if there's wedding invitations coming on and bringing you along, considering you in decisions around moving, talking to you about his dreams and aspirations and what it is that he's trying to build. Those are the types of conversations that a man will want to have with a woman that he's interested in and sees a future with. So if, obviously, you know, those come as you're getting to know one another, but if there's no conversations about the future at all and they seem to be enjoying dating you but also not considering you or integrating you into their life any more than that, it's probably a sign they're wasting your time. And I can speak to personal experience from this. I was dating someone who I thought that, you know, well, not thought that, I did really love. And this person, now I can look back and say that feeling wasn't returned in the same way, but there came a point where we had a conversation about the future, a five-year plan, and everything they described had absolutely nothing to do with me. And I remember being so shook as I was hearing him talk about it that it was almost staring me in the face, like, this man is not considering you in his future because he doesn't see you in his future. And it was a hard pill to swallow, but I actually broke up with him right after following that conversation. And I'm so glad I did. I definitely, you know, reconsidered it a couple days later. I was like, did I jump too fast? But it was the right decision because he showed me what I needed to see, which is that he didn't see me as a part of his future, though he enjoyed dating me. So this is one, watch out for it. It can happen and it can lead to a lot of heartbreak. But I can tell you that on the other side of it, it doesn't mean that person's a bad person, but you've got to continue walking and pursuing what it is that you want. And had I not walked away from that relationship, I might still be being strung along. I was able to meet Adam a couple of months later, actually, after we broke up, and he's an incredible man and the best husband I could ask for. Honestly, like, I've been through some things, y'all. Like, he's awesome. And that brings me to the end of this video, y'all. I have broken a sweat. Okay, it's probably this bathrobe. Anyway, so if you see me sweating, hey, thank you for watching. If you haven't subscribed already, go on and hit that young subscribe and tell me how you're feeling in the comments. Did you like these? Do you have any rebuttals? Are you in a situationship right now? I would love to, you know, show you some love and some encouragement. So feel free to reach out there and I will see you on my next video. Thanks so much.